I hope so too, James. I'm really hoping that he is going to make his rasping, vocalizing call, because it is absolutely amazing. It's this deep, sawing sound, and it really is quite something to hear. It's one of my favorite sounds out here in the African bush, so I do hope that he does make that sound. Now, you can see he is just strolling down the road like he does not care, and that is because he is the territorial male in this area. Anthony, you're asking if leopards lay eggs. Well, no, Anthony. A leopard is a mammal, and what classifies a mammal is something that gives birth to live young and then suckles it by using milk. Whereas things like birds will lay an egg, and then they do not provide any milk for their young. So that is the difference between mammals and birds and reptiles. Reptiles will also lay eggs, some of them. Some of them do give birth to live young as well, but they do not provide milk for their young. So a mammal, like a leopard, gives birth to an animal that is alive already, and then it suckles from its mom and gets milk from its mom, and that is how it survives and grows up to be a big adult, like this male that we see here. Just look how he's just moving down the road. Like I said, this is a territorial male who's just doing a patrol and is just not a care in the world, because he is the dominant male. There's no male that should be in this area, so he knows that he's the biggest of the biggest out in this section, and that's why he can walk around like this. Now, Madison, you're wondering if leopards occur in packs or in groups together. Well, no, they don't. So a leopard is the only true solitary cat of the African plains. So earlier you saw the two cheetah brothers together, so they form coalitions, the two males, and you'll find lions form prides, but the leopards are solitary. So if it's a male leopard, you'll find he's on his own throughout his life. Well, I suppose the first little bit when he's a cub, he might have a sibling, but once he has been kicked out by his mom or the territorial male, he becomes a loner and he's on his own all his life. The females is a little bit different. They are on their own except when they have cubs. So when they have their cubs, then they will have other leopards with them, but it's not essentially a pack or a pride together. It's called a leap of leopards, but it is essentially just a mom and her little cubs, and she looks after them until they're strong enough to go off on their own. And that's normally about a year and a half to 2 years that the little cubs stay with their mom, and then once they reach that age, they're able to hunt for themselves, and they can then find their own food, and she then lets them go and start mating to produce the next litter of cubs that she's going to have. But isn't this incredible? Isn't it amazing to be following a male leopard in the dark? It's really quite something. Jessica, this is an interesting question. You're wondering what color a leopard's eyes are. Well, it depends on the leopard, Jessica. You can see how well they camouflage. So that goes back to our question earlier of how do they camouflage. See how the spots break him up and he can't see him where he's in the bush, and then when he comes out again we can see him. So those spots work really well to hide him. But the eye color is very, very, very different depending on the leopard. So like us as people, we have different eye colors, so do the leopards. So some leopards will have green, some leopards will have blue, some leopards will have yellow, some will have even an amber color eyes. And generally as they get older, their eye color becomes more and more dull and is not as bright as it is when they're a cub. When they're cubs, they're normally born with either bright blue eyes or very, very deep brown amber colored eyes, and sometimes even bright green eyes. But as they get older, it fades a little bit and it becomes a bit more muted, the color, and so it's not as noticeable. But yes, they have different color eyes, just like us as people. But isn't this amazing? Tallwood, you're all wondering whether the leopards are relaxed with us or would they attack us. Well, in the vehicles, they're actually very relaxed. You can see this male. I'm slowly driving behind him, and he has got not a care in the world. He hasn't looked at us once while we've been driving behind him, so he's very, very used to the cars. He knows that the cars are part of his environment, but we're not a threat, so we don't eat him, we don't take food from him, we don't chase him, we don't try hurt him. So he's worked out that it's okay for us to be around and not something that he has to be concerned about. But on foot is a little bit different. So when we are doing bushwalks or we're trying to track these animals, because sometimes what we'll do is when we try and find a leopard is we'll go off on foot and follow his footprints and try and see where they go. And when we do that, then they can potentially attack us, because they are wild animals, and if they feel like they have been cornered or they are threatened or if they've got something that they need to defend, like a food item, then they can be very aggressive and they can be very, very, very dangerous. A leopard is a really big cat and very, very powerful. So for us, it's something that we need to be very, very careful of. There's been a number of people that unfortunately have been attacked by leopards, but where we are in the vehicles, like what we're doing now, is perfectly safe because this leopard knows that we are not a danger to it at all. Now you see how he's rubbing his face, and then he lifts his tail and he sprays his urine all over. So he's trying to mark his territory. It's quite incredible how much urine he does. Ariana, you're wondering what sound a leopard makes, so we were talking about it just now. So there you go, Ariana. I think Tingana heard you and he made the sound for you. Isn't that amazing? So that is the sound that a leopard makes. It is a rasping, roaring call, and it sounds like somebody's sawing wood, and that's going out, and he calls into the ground, and that spreads all over this area, and it tells all the other male leopards that I am here, this is my territory, don't bother coming here because I'm a strong, healthy male. And it also tells females that might want to mate with him that he is around, and the females can then find him. But isn't that amazing? Ariana, I think you've got the most luck in the world, because often leopards don't call for long periods of time, and for you to ask that question and then him to call at the same time is absolutely unbelievable. So you are very, very lucky, Ariana. I'm very happy that he did call. It was perfect, perfect timing. And I'm so glad that he stayed on this road, because we are actually on the boundary of our area. So if he goes north, we can't follow him. So we're very, 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 very fortunate that he's stayed on this road and has walked so far down the road that we can just follow him so gently as he goes. Ashley, you're wondering how many pounds a leopard is and how much he weighs? Well, a male leopard of this size, because we have some of the biggest leopards in the world, he probably weighs about anywhere between 160 and 200 pounds. So he's a very, very heavy cat. He's not quite as heavy as the lions. The lions can weigh up to about 500 pounds, but he is still a very, very big male. And like I was saying, here in the Sabi Sands, in the northeastern part of South Africa, the leopards are some of the biggest in the world, and that's because of the amount of food that we have here. We have a lot of medium-sized antelope and a lot of these warthogs that I was telling you about earlier, so they get a lot of protein in their diet, which allows them to really grow very big and strong. But look at his camouflage. Look at how when he goes in the grass, he disappears. If he dropped his tail and sat very still, you can see how difficult it would be to be able to see him in that grass. Isn't that amazing? So you can see how well camouflaged they are. Now, we're going to carry on following him and see where he goes and if he carries on his territorial patrol. And